Today's the Torch Awards. It's a prestigious awards that honors ethics in business. It's been going on for many, many years. It's a legacy set by the Doug Manship family, and we're here to carry it out. Better Business Bureau stands for trust in business. We seek out the best businesses in the Southeast Louisiana 12 parishes that we service, and we honor awards for those who deserve to be recognized for the ethics that they practice in day-to-day business. Well, I think it's important to have a watchdog group like the Better Business Bureau that stands herd over the scammers that are out there. There's a lot of robocalls. People get approached and solicited by everybody these days on the internet, over their telephones. We're an outlet for people to search and see if the businesses that they are approaching to do business with are in fact ethical. They can do that on our website anytime, anywhere. It's important to join the Better Business Bureau for a plethora of reasons. As a consumer, you want to know that you're doing business with somebody who has ethics. And if you have a problem with them, you have the BBB as an advocate for you to negotiate the right thing between you and the business. As a business, it protects you against the consumer who might be out thrashing you with false reviews and saying things that aren't necessarily true. We get in the middle of that. We make sure that if you're an accredited member, you're protected from that. So it works on both ends. It's who we are and what we do, building trust with business.
People have this persona about the Better Business Bureau that all we do is take complaints, but we take this opportunity to recognize really strong, good, ethical businesses in our community, and that's the beginning of this event. And then we also want to recognize students by giving them scholarships for ethics. And so we're excited about that. We want to recognize businesses and students in a positive manner. We want people to understand that there are great ethical businesses that abide by BBB rules, honor what the Better Business Bureau is really about. And so that's what we want people to understand, and that there are really good businesses, and that the Better Business Bureau takes complaints, but that is a very small part of what we do. It's really important for Louisiana because we want to recognize businesses that do good. In fact, one of the things that we want people to understand is as the Better Business Bureau, again, we talk about complaints. We may receive 350 complaints a year, but we're going to receive over 260,000 pre-purchase inquiries. So people are looking for good businesses. This is a good way to highlight businesses in a positive manner in our area. Better Business Bureau accreditation is by invitation only, so you have to meet and maintain standards. The difference between an accredited member and a non-accredited is that the Better Business Bureau vets these companies. We basically verify that they're properly licensed, that they're free of complaints, so that we know if somebody calls and they want a list of roofers, let's say, then we can give them a list of companies that we vetted, that we know that they didn't just appear on a list. They have to meet standards and have to maintain those standards.
Getting accolades for putting in, like, say, 30 years of some really hard work and somebody along the lines recognizing it. So it is a great honor from the Better Business Bureau for me. Integrity is what we all need, and we can never do it too much of it.
We're here to honor my husband's success with the Better Business Bureau for the Ethics Torch Awards on how truly he has really worked his whole life. And I'm so proud of him to be able to say that I'm his wife and I'm a part of this.
Today we are joining in congratulatory celebrations for some of our local businesses here in Baton Rouge. And being a part of the Better Business Bureau, we like to celebrate and honor those consumers and who have good practices and good behavior in our community. Communication. As long as we pull together and continue to combat any form of fraud and crime, it allows us to get the message out there that the Better Business Bureau has a true place in society, in community, to help fight fraud and any type of prevention against those behaviors. In Louisiana, and like in any other states, we all have our issues and struggles that we go through. But as particularly for Louisiana, we are a growing state. We have a very, very high profile football team, LSU, Southern Universities, and those environments allow potential fraudsters to go in and do harm in our community. So being a part of the Better Business Bureau and an advocate for that being in good behavior, we like to promote that we're here as a support for our community.
Stand behind what you promote. Be honest with people, be upfront with people, and give it your best shot. So I think people need to know that there are businesses out there that do stand behind what they do. They promote honesty, they promote integrity, they promote being involved in the community. If I have a business that stands behind what they do, then I know they have my back, that they have my best interest in what I'm trying to achieve.
It's a gathering of the South Central Louisiana Better Business Bureau, and they're honoring a number of businesses in the community as well as some young people with scholarship tonight, and we're excited to be able to showcase these young people. And my role tonight is I'm the keynote address speaker and going to be sharing music and message, helping people understand that we all have a sound and there's a power to keep on going. We're known for great sound, we're known for great music, but it's our people, as much as the community and the culture, it's our people that make the difference. Folks tell me from all over the world, when they come to Louisiana, the folks are just different here. It's a down-home feel, it's a love that you feel in the spirit. And for us today, I think it's important that people remember and realize how important our greatest resource is, our people and the sound we all make.
I'm a recipient of the Better Business Bureau Torch Awards for Ethics. Today we're honoring the four recipients of the award as well as the businesses that sponsored the Torch Awards. As a society, for us to grow and expand in ethics, I feel like it's important for us to look at our moral choices and help that society, not in just our state, but around the world. It's important for Louisiana because as a state, if we show that we're making ethical choices and we can change our society, then it'll leave an impact on the rest of the country.
It means a lot because ethics means a lot to me, and I feel like that's a part of your everyday life. Ethics is what you carry around with you. Every day when you step out to the real world to, you know, help out one another and just be yourself in everything you do and treat people how you want to be treated. Typically, people don't see the positive that comes out of Louisiana, so I want to help get that out and see that, you know, a lot of good things come out of Louisiana as well.
I'm a recipient of the Ethics Torch Award, and I'm very excited to be here and very appreciative for receiving this award. It's very important to me to know that businesses focus on ethics both individually and communally so that they can have great business. I would like to show that ethics are very important. They show how people can grow both mentally, physically, spiritually, all the above to move forward in society. Louisiana has a great foundation for ethics, and it's great for people to understand that and to understand that as winners we both represent Louisiana. It's very important to me because I hold myself to a very high standard, and ethics are very important to me both individually and communally as well. So to represent myself in society is this way is very appreciative that I got this award.
It means a lot to me because it shows that not only am I living my life in an ethical manner, but I'm also allowing my character and integrity to lead me, and it's very important. We're a growing state. We're trying to move up and improve, and ethics is definitely a way to do that.
This event was established as recognition for high ethical standards towards customers, suppliers, employees, and the communities in which they do business. The history of Doug Manship, the Senior Award, Doug's guiding principle was reflected in his requirement that all of his organizations, Capital City Press owned 2 television stations and 5 radio stations, by the way, must be fair, honest, and operate with the highest integrity in their services, hence the name the Torch Awards. Mike is the chairman of the board of the Better Business Bureau of South Central Louisiana. I'd like to ask Mike to please join me at the podium for your comments. Everybody, Mr. Mike Benson.
In 2019, the BBB processed 508 reportable complaints and handled over 263,000 pre-purchase inquiries. We have completed 46 investigations on questionable practices and challenged 17 companies on their advertising. Always look for the seal and search accredited businesses at bbb.org/search. Our vision is to create an ethical marketplace where buyers and sellers trust each other. Our mission is to be the leader in advancing marketplace trust. We do this by setting standards for marketplace trust, encouraging and supporting best practices by engaging with and educating consumers and businesses, celebrate marketplace role models, calling out and addressing substandard marketplace behavior, and creating a community of trustworthy businesses and charities. I met Carmen, in Atlanta, I went to a Better Business Bureau symposium with all of the other directors from across the country, around the world. There were people from Canada, there were people from Mexico, all around the world, the BBB is represented. And I was there to recruit a new person to come to Baton Rouge. And when I met Carmen, she was like, yeah, I'm happy in Lake Charles. And I knew her husband was an LSU fan. So I told him we could get you good seats to the games. I'll introduce you to Gordy Rush. And she was there like the next day she called. So tell me more about this gig. So we're glad to have you, Carmen. Thank you.
My husband, who really is the one who talked me into moving to Baton Rouge because I really didn't want to. I've been here a year and 4 months Friday. And Mike said a while ago, my husband loves LSU. And so we moved to Baton Rouge and he retired. So my husband, Alan. And I will tell you this. He had to follow me. Tomorrow is our wedding anniversary. Yes, we got married on Halloween. We will be married 38 years. And then I'd also, I mean, everybody already knows BJ Militello. BJ is... And then I have also another person that I wanted to recognize, and she's kind of shy too. But Joanne Textor, and Joanne is my office manager. She is the one that makes sure I make the meetings and what have you. Thank you for coming. I really appreciate it. I appreciate everybody showing up. I appreciate the board and all the advocates and for helping me feel welcome in Baton Rouge. I've built a house. I'm staying here. I'm not going anywhere unless you guys fire me, and then I'm looking for a job. Other than that, I'm sticking around. I hope that you guys see BBB everywhere. That's what we're trying to do, and I know with GatorWorks, we're going to really push that. We're on the TV stations all the time, and thank you guys for the media and for helping us get the word out. And I have a motto, I will never tell them no. So if they call me, I'm there no matter what. They've even been to my house. So, you know, it's all about the Better Business Bureau. And I'm just going to say one other thing before we get to the script, and I know BJ's probably having a cow, but if I did nothing else coming to this area, I have to take credit for bringing the speaker. And I just want to tell y'all, he is awesome. He's gonna show y'all later, but I'm telling y'all, he's actually from my part of town, Lake Charles. So I just want to say. So what we'd like to do, and Greg, if you'd come up here, and Mike Vincent, if you'd come up here, we're going to give away the Youth Scholarship Awards. I want to tell you that our annual Youth Scholarship Award program, because of Greg and his team, brought in over 37 applications completed. In the last couple of years, I know that we gave away one scholarship, and we just know there's so much need that we charged Greg with trying to give as many as he felt were... I mean, there were so many of them that were great, but we wanted to at least choose four. And he came up with four great ones, and I think he did a great job. Better Business Bureau is about education, right? And so this is what this is about. It's about the Torch Awards the Students Awards for Ethics is about education. And so we want to give each student a $1,500 scholarship. And our first winner is Maya Alford from Woodland High School. And the next winner is Claire Holder from St. Joseph's Academy. Claire? The next winner is J.C. Holliday from West Feliciana High School. And of course, last but not least, is Emily Reynold from St. Joseph's Academy.
Doug Manship's guiding principle was reflected in his requirements that all of his organizations, the Capital City Press, own 2 TV stations and 5 radio stations, must be fair, they must be honest, and operate with the highest integrity in their services. Hence the Torch Awards. They set this up. That's why it's the Manship Torch Awards. We want to recognize the previous winners here. I'd like to announce winners of each of our Ethics and Business Awards and ask each winner to stay for photos and other presentations. But first, along that wall of fame over there on that side, are all of the previous Torch Award winners who we honor. If there are any previous winners here, please take a stand and let us see you. So I'm going to announce the company names. You'll see them on the video screens, and we'll have some brief remarks from each of them. I'd like to ask last year's winner in these categories to please come up to do indeed the honors of passing the torch to our new ethics winners. First of all, Dale Buys Houses was the winner of the 2018 award for small business, 1 to 10 employees. Wendell Evans, salt of the earth. Wendell's become a good friend of ours, and I think many of you in this room know Wendell and how involved he is in the community, and he runs a tight ship and a very ethical ship with Dale Buys Houses. Come on up, Wendell. We're going to have you pass the torch to the 2019 winner for 1 to 10 employees. Ladies and gentlemen, it's our honor to award Brothers Construction Company of Baton Rouge, represented by Harry Wells. The 2019 winner for Big Business, 11 to 99 employees last year. Falk and Winkler, CPA, represented by Tommy Lejeune. That'll be presented by last year's winner, Accutemp Services, represented by Alex Darden. Come on down. Pass the torch, please. Again, congratulations to the 2019 Torch Award winners. This is the time that we bring on our guest speaker, and we're doing something a little different this year. We've never had a Grammy Award winner. Well, you know what? We had Percy Sledge here about 4 or 5 years ago, just before he passed away. So I'm going to take that back. But ladies and gentlemen, Mickey Smith Jr. is one of the most dynamic educators and musicians today. A recipient of numerous awards, Mickey's work in music has been recognized by various organizations, including the Recording Academy, the Grammy Foundation, and as a saxophonist, speaker, and author, his music and message embodies a level of expression that resonates with ensembles and audiences alike. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Mickey Smith Jr.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening. It's a pleasure to be here. Once again, my name is Mickey Smith Jr., and truly, this is an incredible event. Just seeing the room filled and the energy. Had a chance to meet a few folks before we got started, and I'd be remiss if I didn't first just say thank you. Thank you for trusting me with the opportunity to be before you today. Carmen, thank you so much. Thank you. It's an absolute pleasure to be with you today. And the great thing is, even though I'm from down the street, so to speak, I feel like I'm at home because I see so many friendly faces. I see at least 10 folks in here tonight that I have personal relationship with. And anytime you come to a place and you feel like you're home, that's a special thing. And for me, a place called home is a thing called music. And today I definitely want to share with you a little bit about what makes all of our journeys so significant and why this moment is so powerful. But if I can first, I would like to share a little bit of song with you. For me, music is critical to what I do. When I'm not in front of you guys, I'm usually in front of a very, very, I can call them anything. I usually call them the midget mafia, the middle school mafia. It's a tough crowd, y'all. Those adolescents, I'm a teacher. And I tell you, you know, you can fool a fool, but you can't kid a kid, I'm telling you. Sometimes that's the toughest audience. And it's definitely good to be in the room with folks over the age of 12. I'm just saying.
Thank you.
Much in class, he draws too much in class, and he's always making noise, he's always making music. Little did I know growing up I'd be paid to talk too much. I'd have a book to my credit that I authored and illustrated, inspiring my young people to keep on going. And that music thing might have panned out, I don't know. I share that because, again, sometimes our deficiencies are actually our gifts in disguise. And I'm speaking to a room full of entrepreneurs. I'm speaking to a room of folks who maybe don't always do it the conventional way. There's something special about an individual that can create nothing or create something from nothing. It takes a certain level of creativity and understanding, empathy and understanding of others, and just that tenacity to make things work. There's so much gifting in this room today. You heard my sound, but I believe everybody has a sound. It may not be a saxophone necessarily, but everyone has a unique personal significance, something that they bring to this world that no one else can bring quite like you do.
See, your sound is as unique as the thumbprint that you possess. And I believe that each and every one of us has a sound. So today, I'm not speaking to an audience. I believe I'm speaking to a symphony, an ensemble. You're what makes our community incredible. Not in and of yourself, but together. I believe we're better when we band together. That's what I believe in. That's what I see each and every day. And when I go places around the country, I always tell folks I'm from Louisiana. I tell them I'm representing the blues. This is home for me. And that's powerful because a lot of times folks come down here and they know about the food, they know about the culture, but our greatest resource is our people. So when I see a room like this of individuals who have attained that level of success, but then don't keep it to themselves, pay it forward, play it forward, pour it into that next generation. And I believe every child is one sound adult away from discovering the sound of success. It's so easy to be average in today's society that when we see young people that are stepping up and putting forth that extra effort, that speaks a lot, not only to them, but the families they represent too. We commend you today, parents and families, for supporting them. It takes a village, more so now than it ever has before. When I teach these young people, I'm reminded that what I do is not just teach them music. Oh yeah, I've been recognized and honored by the Grammys for my music education. I've been a Teacher of the Year candidate and winner. But I don't say that to impress you. I say this to impress upon you the fact that none of that stuff matters. I've never had a kid come back to me later and say, Mr. Smith, you made the difference because of your credentials. I've been waiting. It hasn't happened yet. The stats are nice, I'm telling you, but the kids don't care. They don't care. See, I believe the classroom is a lot like the business world in that our job is not necessarily the bottom line or to make sales. Our job is engagement. We're trying to engage. And when I'm in the classroom, my job is not to teach, but it's to reach. It's not to instruct, but it's to inspire. And we can do that a number of different ways. For me, that opportunity comes with each opportunity. And I tell my kids all the time, every opportunity is another opportunity for another opportunity. That's what I see. I don't see problems, I see opportunities. Every child that comes in, I see another opportunity. And I believe that they understand and they feel that. There's an old adage that says, preach at all times, but when necessary, use words. Kids don't care how much you know until they what? Know how much you care. Again, you can con a con. You can fool a fool. But you can't kid a kid. And the people that we serve, our patrons, our clients, our customers, they're the same too. We live in a society more than ever that really doesn't care about the product as much as they care about the person that stands behind that product. So I tell my young people all the time when I'm working with them, you know, make sure that your sound, resonates and that your sound is true. Make sure that your sound is what it is, not only in the classroom, but make sure you represent yourselves honorably outside the classroom. I started off with that song, I Will Always Love You, because at the end of the day, we should be showing love, we should be showing support. That's what tonight is all about. That's what these incredible honorees represent. They represent the love from their families. They represent the love of their community. These businesses, that's a labor of love. How many of y'all know there's parts that no one sees, there's parts that no one knows? There's work and labor that doesn't always show. The average person doesn't know what goes into it. Folks, they see this horn, they see the shine, but they don't understand the time that you gotta work at this. It's a craft, you gotta grind it out, so to speak. And I tell my students that I don't mind being transparent with them and being honest. In the first days, I'm gonna be honest with you, everybody loves my music class. The first week. Until they figure out they gotta practice. What? It doesn't just play itself? Nah, you gotta work it. It doesn't work unless you work it. So I begin to tell them the story about how I got started. And I'm gonna be honest with y'all. I'll tell you like I tell the kids, my first sounds, I gotta be honest, my first sounds were amazing on this instrument. I put that horn in my lips, my grandma bought the horn for me. And my whole family gathered around, nobody had played before me. I had nobody to look to. I was figuring this thing out as I went. Much like many of my business owners who stepped out that first time, you figure this out daily. And I put that horn in my lips, and I'll be honest, first sound was amazing. Hey! amazingly terrible. It was bad. It was bad. But watch this. The next thing that happened made such an impact in my life. It changed everything for me. My mom stepped in, and she looked at me, and she said, "Son, I see something special in you. I don't know exactly what it is, but I know this. If you keep on going, you'll be successful." The only problem with that is, when she said that, she walked over to the front door, she opened it, and she said, "Son, I see something special in you. I don't know what it is, but if you keep on going, outside, if you keep on going, you'll be successful." You can't make that noise in here. They kicked me out of the house, y'all. That's not like somebody's praying in here. I'm being real with you. They sent me outside. So there I am. I go outside the door. I get on the front steps, and I put that horn to my lips because I'm not a quitter, y'all. I'm not a quitter. I'm not going to give up on it. And I said, "I'm going to make this thing play." My mom stuck her head out the door. She said, "Son, keep on going." I said, "That's the driveway." She said, "I know." So I walk down the driveway. I get all the way down the driveway. We grew up in a rural setting, a little town. It's not even there anymore. It's gone. But at the time, it was called Mossville, Louisiana. A little big town, about that big. And so I go down the driveway, and I put that horn to my lips. Watch this. I didn't even get a sound out of the horn. My mom miraculously sticks her head out the window, and she says, "Hey, keep on going." I said, "Mama, that's the woods across the street." She said, "I know. Go." True story. Sent me across the street to the woods. So there I am in the woods. Forest for our sophisticated folks out there. I'm out here in the woods, and I'm playing this horn, but I'm going to tell you this. That moment taught me so much about everything else. And I'm speaking to a room right now. I think that can connect with what I'm about to say. See, sometimes when you're doing something that has not been done before, young people, business owners, when you're doing something that you have not seen done before, sometimes you don't have anybody to lean on. Sometimes you gotta do some crazy stuff like encourage yourself. So when I was out there in the woods, I'd have to say these words to myself. I'm a teacher, y'all, so I need participation. When I point to you, I want y'all to say, "Keep on going." That's what I'm talking about. One more time.
Keep on going.
So when I point to you, I need you to say that. When I'd be out there in the woods, sometimes the note wouldn't come out.
Keep on going.
That's what I had to tell myself.
Keep on going.
But like the kids say, I tried it twice.
Keep on going.
Man, I've been working on this so long, I don't think it's getting better. Not initially. But one day, I was out there playing, and I tell you that specifically because for me, I love the process. I tell my students that success is not a destination, it's a direction. If you can get lost and fall in love with the process, then you never have to work a day in your life. I haven't worked in years. Don't tell my school system that, but you know what I mean. I haven't worked in years. Because they don't know what I'm doing right now, I'd do it for free if it weren't for those mouths I have to feed at home. I have a Feed the Children Foundation at the house. You got to take care of them. So I tell the students, when I was out there, I was just practicing because I loved it so much. I didn't even notice that one day my dad came home from work, as he often would. My dad was a longshoreman. He worked at the docks. One time I made a D in chemistry. That was the last D I ever made because my dad decided to bring me to work with him. I was like, sweet! Had no idea what my dad did. Anybody knows what longshoremen are, like working the docks? Okay, they throw 100, 110 pound sacks all day long. You think your car is hot when you park it at the mall? Okay, the boxcar's been sitting there for like months. It's tangible heat. And you gotta work in that. I was like, no. After I finished that week, I was like, I need to go to college. I need air conditioning. Well, my dad came home that day, and he walks into the house, and I wasn't aware of what was happening, but I understand later that when he walked in, that same woman who told me to keep on going now said, "Do you hear him?" My dad goes, "Yeah, I hear him. Boy never stops. He just keeps on going. He never stops practicing." She said, "No, listen, shh. He actually sounds good." Again, this is all hearsay. I wasn't there to hear it because I was outside, lost in the process. And young people, I'll tell you this, many decisions made about you will happen when you're not in the room. So never forget your ability to get lost in that positive process will ultimately open up doors of opportunity for you later. And that's what happened for me. The next thing I remember is the door opened and they said, "Come in." Man, why did they say that? It was on them, that you couldn't tell me anything. I said, "Oh man." I tell you that because right now, even sharing the story with you, I can picture that moment so vividly. I've been awarded and recognized, but my parents opening up that door meant more to me and still means more to me than just about anything that's happened in my life, because when they opened up that door, it's like they said, "I see you." They were saying, "You're loved, you're valued, you're wanted." Bob is over there killing the game right now. Bob got me going at the Grammys and stuff, man. Like, the transitions are smooth, everything. You never notice some things until they aren't there. Yeah, Bob, much love. And me and Bob met earlier during what we call the sound check. We make sure everything was tight. Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. And each day, I make sure that I do a personal sound check. And I want to share with you what the sound is. Sound is an acronym. S stands for see yourself beyond yourself. And whether it's in the classroom or in the boardroom, I believe the greatest thing that you can do is see beyond. I tell my students all the time that your posture causes you to prosper. In essence, a giraffe and a turtle can occupy the same space, but a giraffe will see things and eat from places a turtle could never even dream of. There's nothing wrong with the turtle, he just doesn't have that perspective. He doesn't have that limb, he doesn't have that posture. So when you can position yourself to see things that others can't see, then you become incredibly valuable. Make a practice of seeing beyond your limitations, seeing beyond maybe your own shortcomings, seeing the community that you serve. Because when you see the people more than you see the product, then the product takes care of itself. The next thing is operate in optimism and excellence daily. That one's tough. I know this because there's a place called social media. And when I go to it, I don't see a lot of optimism and excellence. I'm just being real with you. It's almost like a dumping ground. And what happens is that social media begins to permeate our society. And now we see a lot of that in everyday actions. That's why, well, to talk about ethics in a room like this and to model that for our young people, how powerful is that? It's incredible. So I tell folks, operate in optimism and excellence each day. Somebody said, "Mickey, what are you talking about? Fake it till you make it?" Maybe. For other folks, you talk about fake it till you make it? Nothing wrong with that. But I want you to consider this. Face it till you make it. Because what you have in you is greater than anything that can come against you. Next is utilize all available resources. Utilize all available resources. I think about the Wright brothers. I can't even imagine what was that like, telling people, "We're gonna fly." To folks that have never seen a plane before. See, we say that today, you're like, oh, we just need to roll out to Seattle or wherever, Boeing is, right? Right? Go out to the Northwest and make a plane, because that's what they do. But where do you make a plane when a plane's never been made before? Well, if you ask the Wright brothers, you make it in a bicycle shop. What are you saying? Utilize what you have. Utilize all available resources. Don't worry about what you don't have. It's not a matter of what's lost, because I hear a lot of people saying that too. Hey, I lost this, I'll never be able to recover. Don't look at what's lost, look at what's left. Because again, what you have is enough. You're looking at a little fella that came from a little town that a lot of people overlooked. And now they come back like, man, we knew you were gonna make it. No, you didn't. But it's great to say, I appreciate it. Because nobody really expected a lot from that particular place where I came from. But what people didn't realize is there was so much heart in that place. You can't quantify that. That's why I say what's inside of you is greater than anybody can measure. You just have to believe. And then after utilizing all available resources, here's a big one, and we're losing this one fast. Nourish relationships. Isn't it ironic that with almost 8 billion people, and with social media that can connect, I think it's something like 4 billion or 5 billion people of the 8 billion, that people feel lonelier now more than ever. I look at young people and sometimes they can't even look you in the eye. They can't make eye contact. They can't conversate. Oh, I'm telling you folks, the young and young at heart, that your ability to engage, to educate, and to elevate in that personal manner is going to distinguish you. Because it can't just be about facts. Because if it's just about facts and figures, I hate to break it to you. They got this thing called Google. It's gonna beat you every time. I tried to beat it. Google is smarter than me. But what Google and what AI can't do, it can't have that human element yet. It can't have that personal element. I ask kids, what's the difference? Why do you enjoy this class so much? And 9 times out of 10 when I talk to a child about a class they enjoy, it's because of the experience. I challenge you right now. Think about your favorite teacher. Take a second, think about it. I promise you, when you thought about that individual, you did not think about what they taught you first as much as you felt the way they made you feel. You remember the way they made you feel more than what they taught you. And I'm telling you, in this season of social media, this season of technology and information, don't lose the heart. Connect with others, nourish relationships, because life moves at the speed of relationships more than anything. And this opportunity, young people, you're in this room today, you connect and network with folks. The business owners, y'all understand that. That's why we're here today. Let's teach our young people the value of networking. And then finally, D, the most important letter in the word sound. It says simply, don't stop. I know y'all looking for something deep, but I'm gonna be real with you. Don't stop. I was just talking to somebody earlier today. Matter of fact, I was talking to what? Brothers Construction. Yeah, we were talking about that. The most important thing you can do in this journey called success is not quit, is not give up. Because I've seen it so many times, you're right there at the cusp of it. I used to run cross country and track. I wasn't better than everybody else. I just was more stubborn. I just had more tenacity, right? I was so stubborn, I was literally gonna die before I just let you pass me up. And you know what? I came out pretty good on that. We had a few little district championships and everything else, just based off of the fact that I made up my mind that I was gonna attain something special. There's nothing special about me. I just set my mind to something special. Don't quit, don't give up. Or like mama said, y'all know I'm a teacher, I had to bring it back. Like mama said, keep on going. Your success is there. If you just don't quit, if you just don't faint, you'll get that reward. But it comes in a season. It comes at a particular time. You just got to keep going. So every day we get this opportunity to create a sound. I challenge you today to ask the question, what's your sound? Y'all say that with me. Say, what's your sound? Look at the person next to you. Say, what's your sound? What's your sound? Yeah. You better find out, because I'm telling you, there's some unique personal significance in this room today. And sometimes we think we know somebody. When you saw me today, you saw the saxophone. You thought you knew my sound, but really my sound is my ability to engage, to educate, to elevate. And you wouldn't know that if you hadn't taken time to hear a sound. So I ask you again, what's your sound? Every day we get an opportunity to live out our sound. Every day we are the symphony that can change the world. As I close with this, I let you know about a student I once had. And every day I meet my students at the door and I greet them as they come in. And I need you to understand, there's so many of our students that come to school with two backpacks. There's one backpack you can see, and there's another backpack that's invisible. And they're carrying so many things that you couldn't even imagine. There are children that are dealing with problems that will cripple or crush adults. And every day they show up to school with that backpack. And I believe the effective teachers are those that know how to unpack that backpack and allow them to experience this thing called life in a way that's appropriate for a young person. And on this particular day, I'm at the door and I'm greeting them. I used to say, good morning, you know, how you doing? I wave at them. I give them dap. I don't do handshakes. It's middle school. I give them dap and let them in. But on this day, this young person walked up to my classroom and she had her head hung a little low. And I looked at her and I said, hey, I see you. She just hung her head a little bit lower. So what I did was I got down there with her because I'm stubborn. I'm like, you're not going to ignore. I got something good for you today. And I said, hey, I see you. And she looked up a little bit. She smiled, a little crooked smile. And she put her head back down and walked into the band hall. Never said another word. We went about our day. Didn't think anything more of it. 4 years later, before the Grammys, before anything, before the Today Show, before any of this stuff that I've been so blessed and privileged to experience, I was like so many teachers and so many business owners, and I felt like quitting. I said, man, this thing ain't working. I just keep giving, and I don't really see where the benefit of the reward is coming. And there's so many folks out there that feel like that at times. It doesn't make you a bad person, you're just human. And I decided, I went home that day, I was gonna write my letter of resignation. I sat down at the table with my paper and my pen. Coincidentally, I came home that day, checked the mail, and I got three handwritten letters in the mail. That's the last time you got a handwritten letter. That just doesn't happen. Or sometimes you get one and it's the trick. Have y'all ever seen those, they get so fancy with the printing out, it looks handwritten, you're like, ah, they got me, right? So I looked at it, I said, oh, this is actually handwritten. So I opened it up. It was from three students who were given a task by a 12th grade teacher. And that task was, I need you to think about the most impactful person in your school career. Could be teacher, counselor, custodian, principal, whoever. Most impactful, cafeteria worker, bus driver, anybody. And I want you to write them a thank you letter. Three students wrote me a letter that year. But here's the crazy part. Not one of those three students continued with the subject that I taught, band. Think about that. That was a powerful moment for me because it was a reminder that it's not solely about the subject matter, but it's about showing the young person that they matter. Let us be Can you hear the sound, heartbeat of that mother's child? As we search for love, we all need warmth of a smile. There's a sound that is so sweet when we hear, child, you belong. So let our words of love flow freely like a river strong.
I think I'll let it sound.
Easier for that to happen. I would encourage anybody who wants to engage with our Better Business Bureau for the 12 parishes that we serve to please reach out to one of the officers to find out your path to becoming one of us. We do appreciate our businesses that are here, the award winners, past and present, and who wants to be 2020's class of ethics winners? Oh my goodness, I'm overwhelmed with the people that came and the love that we shared in the room and the businesses, past award winners and future award winners, and mostly the pride of those who we passed the torch to tonight for the 2019 Torch Awards.